Let's talk about sex in men after spinal cord injury. The authors of this paper have produced a really interesting piece that I would like to talk a little bit about. Sexuality is a basic human need, yet people living with a spinal cord injury are sometimes told they need to disregard this aspect of their lives due to the change in their body. Even if someone's ability to move and feel touch changes, their desire and importance of sexuality may not change. Interestingly, in the past, a lot of focus has been placed on finding out how it physically impacts on men living with such an injury. Whilst this is an important topic, it's often not bodily dysfunction that actually has the most notable impact on sexuality. But instead, other things can play a role. For example, people can feel anxious, view themselves in a negative way, be distressed or feel unattractive, or have an understandable fear of being rejected. However, people living with a spinal cord injury may still experience satisfaction with their sex life. This current article looked at the emotional side of sex and how people's views may change because of the injury. Part of supporting people experiencing spinal cord injury is about providing them with relevant information, so it's important to capture the different aspects of sexuality after injury. What did the researchers actually do? Well, the researchers did interviews with people to find out more as a part of a qualitative study. See the glossary for more details if you're interested in. They didn't really walk in with a lot of pre-baked ideas about what they may find out, but instead they were trying to approach it openly, and they were led by the data collected in the study to later come up with an explanation or theory as to how things fit together. They used what is called a descriptive phenomenological method, which is a fancy way of saying the researcher tried to find out what was most important aspect about the topic of interest, so in this case sexuality and spinal cord injury, as described by the people who are directly experiencing it. The key is that people who are participating in this research are expert by experience. So you don't need many participants in this kind of study, but instead the focus is on the deeper level of detail of the individual's experience. So who actually participated in the study? The researchers selected people that were interested in participating in the study who could shine some light on the topic. So, 6 male participants between the ages of 24 and 49 living in Canada with a spinal cord injury were included. These men had been living between just under a year to over 29 years with a spinal cord injury, and all identified as heterosexual. 3 of them had children, 2 of which had them before the injury. 4 were married, 1 in a relationship, and the last participant was separated from their spouse. And all but one reported being sexually active since the injury happened. The next thing is what they actually found out in the interviews. So each man was interviewed for an average of 81 minutes. And there were some pre-prepared questions like, what is the meaning of sexuality for you? And some other open-ended questions. All interviews were audio recorded and then typed into a written version. 2 researchers independently read and coded the data to come up with broader themes across the different interviews. And now you want to know what they found. Well, all men confirmed that stereotypes and common beliefs about sexuality, masculinity and disability and attractiveness definitely exist. Changing their view of how these ideas are perceived helped them to accept themselves more. And themes that they have identified included: being physical is now only a relatively small part of sexuality as a whole, and they feel it also includes emotions and intimacy in a broader sense. The more they found this to be true, actually, the more satisfied they were with their sex life currently. Secondly, classic aspects of masculinity, so strength, physicality, dominance, assertiveness, etc., are less relevant to them now. and so they're viewed differently. For example, strength in being vulnerable and asking for support rather than physical strength was valued. Thirdly, society now views them differently. And due to society's lack of understanding and knowledge of the condition, they found that sometimes other people seem to find it really difficult to interact with them or only see the disability. And lastly, some of the men felt less attractive, were unhappier with their body after the injury occurred, and have some fear of rejection, which is also linked to struggles with achieving an erection or ejaculating. Many people living with a spinal cord injury feel that better sex life would really improve their quality of life and mood. Although the most common sexual issues for men after spinal cord injuries, so for instance problems with having an erection or ejaculating, can often be effectively managed, for example with mechanical help and sometimes medication, this study was one of the first ones to consider the psychological impact of sexual problems arising from spinal cord injury. The men in this study found it hard to overcome society's stereotypes or norms, so addressing these issues directly may be an important part of rehabilitation after one injury occurs, which has so far been neglected. Thank you very much for watching this lay summary. Here are the credits for all the pictures used.